أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وإخوانه وحزبه إلى يوم الدين. اللهم إنا أصبحنا بحمدك نشهدك ونشهد حملة عرشك وملائكتك وجميع خلقك أنك أنت الله لا إله إلا أنت وأن سيدنا محمدا عبدك ورسولك. رضينا بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبسيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيا ورسولا. اللهم ما أصبح بنا من نعمة أو بأحد من خلقك فمنك وحدك لا شريك لك، فلك الحمد ولك الشكر على ذلك. أصبحنا وأصبح الملك لله، أصبحنا وأصبح الملك لله، أصبحنا وأصبح الملك لله، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. أصبحنا على فطرة الإسلام وعلى كلمة الإخلاص وعلى دين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى ملة أبينا إبراهيم حنيفا وما كان من المشركين. اللهم إنا نسألك خير هذا اليوم وخير ما بعده، ونعوذ بك من شر هذا اليوم وشر ما بعده. اللهم إنا نسألك خير هذا اليوم، نصره وفتحه ونوره وبركته وهداه. اللهم اجعل يومنا خيرا من أمسنا، واجعل غدنا خيرا من يومنا، واجعل خير أيامنا وأسعدها يوم نلقاك وأنت راض عنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا أصبحنا منك في نعمة وعافية وستر، فأتم علينا نعمتك وعافيتك وسترك في الدنيا وفي الآخرة يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين. My dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this morning a new beginning for all of us, a new beginning for our hearts and for our families and for our ummah, for the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. In this second morning of the i'tikaf, I would like to share with you a reminder. Yesterday we talked about the first attribute of a faith, and that was the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And today I would like to share with you some ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the importance of the dhikr and remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And first, in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remind us in many, many ayat and many contexts in the Quran about the importance of dhikr and how we should really remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all times and under all circumstances and conditions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا ذُكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. Oh, you who believe, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot. اُذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا, and glorify Him day and night, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. Those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those who believe, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, those who believe and their hearts find peace in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. Indeed, it is with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that hearts find peace and tranquility. And if we keep searching in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will find a lot of ayat. Dhikr is the purpose of our ibadah. Our ibadat are aimed to elevate us to a state where we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We connect with the divine. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, أَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِ, establish prayers to remember me. So even the main pillar of our deen, which is salah, is aimed to awaken our hearts and to bring our hearts to a state of consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and awareness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we find constant reminders about the importance of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala against all the other ibadat, and that the dhikr should be the purpose of any ibadah that we engage at. And I would like to share with you this hadith that was reported to us by Sayyidina Mu'adh ibn Anas, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, O Messenger of Allah, who amongst the Mujahideen is the best? Who amongst the Mujahideen is the best? And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قال أكثرهم لله ذكرا, said, the best of the Mujahideen is the one who remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most. And then the man said, قال فأي الصائمين أعظم أجرا, and he said, who is among the fasting people has the best reward? And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قال أكثرهم لله ذكرا, that the best of the sa'imeen in rewards are those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot. Then the man kept asking Rasulullah sallallahu about who is the best in prayer, and who is the best in zakah, and who is the best in hajj, and who is the best in sadaqah. And every time Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أكثرهم لله ذكرا, that the best among those who pray and those who give zakah and those who go for hajj and those who go give sadaqah are those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot. Then Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said to Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, Ya Aba Hafs, ذهب الذاكرون الله بكل خير. Sayyidina Abu Bakr told Sayyidina Umar, when he heard those responses of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, O Umar, O Abu Hafs, the Dhakirun of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the best among all people. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam confirmed that by saying, قال أجل, indeed that is true. Subhanallah, you can see that the dhikr is what really elevates our ibadah to be among the best of the ibadat. And in another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as it was reported by Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu wa ardah, and the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was passing by a mountain close to Mecca. And then the mountain's name is Jumdan. So Rasulullah while passing by the mountain, he said, قال سيروا هذا جمدان سبق المفردون. He said to the Sahaba, keep walking. This is Jumdan. This is the mountain of Jumdan. Truly, the Mufarridun are the best. They said, قالوا وما المفردون. They said, who are the مفردون, O Messenger of Allah? قال الذاكرون الله كثيرا والذاكرات. He said, the مفردون are those believers, men and women, who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala abundantly. They remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot. So subhanallah, you can see that the dhikr is really the core of our deen. And our ibadat are all aimed to, as I said before, to elevate us to a state of remembrance and a consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Sayyidina Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, may Allah be pleased with him, also reported that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَكْثِرُوا ذِكْرَ اللَّهِ حَتَّى يَقُولُوا مَجْنُونَ. Said, say, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot until people say this person has lost his mind out of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. SubhanAllah, and in another narration, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked about al-mufarridun, who are the mufarridun? And he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قال المستهثرون في ذكر الله يضع الذكر عنهم أثقالهم فيأتون يوم القيامة خفافا. said al-mustahthirun, al-mufarridun are those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala abundantly, right? Al-mustahthiruna fi dhikrillah. They remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala under all conditions and circumstances. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says, Ya alladhina, ya ayyuha الذين يذكرون الله قياما إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم. Those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while standing, قياما وقعودا, while sitting down, وعلى جنوبهم, and while laying down, which means that they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all conditions, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And there was a man who came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Busr reported. He said, a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then he said, قَالَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ إِنَّ شَرَائِعَ الْإِسْلَامِ قَدْ كَثُرَتْ عَلَيَّ فَأَوْصِنِي بِشَيْءٍ أَتَشَبَّتُ بِهِ. He came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, O Messenger of Allah, The teachings, the rules, and the regulations of the deen are so many that I cannot afford them. And I got now to a point where I don't know what to start with or what to do or what to prioritize. Then he said, O Messenger of Allah, tell me one thing to stick to, and so that I'm not confused and that I'm not lost. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, قال لا يزال لسانك رطبا من ذكر الله. Make sure that your tongue is always moist because of the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dear brothers and sisters, and if we keep searching, we will find more and more ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam emphasizing the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is important, its importance in our lives. In another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قال مثل الذي يذكر ربه والذي لا يذكر ربه كمثل الحي والميت. The example of the believer and of the person who remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the one who doesn't remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is similar to a dead person and a live person, right? Subhanallah, it is dhikr that give us life, and it is headlessness that really make us like dead people, right? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the dhakirin. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to elevate our hearts to a state where they are always remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and engaging in his remembrance subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the dhakirin in this i'tikaf. You know, we are in these days of the i'tikaf, and one of the best ibadat is to find times in the day where we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we make dhikr by saying the tasbih subhanallah wa bihamdih, by saying the tahleel, la ilaha illallah, by sending prayers upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. All of that is dhikr. By making istighfar during the sahar time specifically. Wal mustaghfirin bil ashar. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the mustaghfirin bil ashar. My dear brothers and sisters, I conclude with one of the best one of the adhkar that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam recommended to Sayyida Aisha radiyallahu anha wa ardaha. When she asked him, she said, "Qalt ma aqul ya Rasulullah ma aqul idha kanat laylatul qadr." What should I say if I witness the night of laylatul qadr? And then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Qala ya Aisha, قولي اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عني. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عني. O Allah, you are the most forgiving, the most generous, so forgive me, Ya Allah." Right? So let us keep this dhikr and this dua on our tongues during the last 10 days of Ramadan, as well as we should dedicate certain times in the day just to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as I said, by saying La ilaha illallah, by saying Subhanallah wa bihamdi, by sending prayers upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by making istighfar. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the dhakirin Allah kathiran wa dhakirat. Innahu ala ma yasha'u qadir. Wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallama tasliman kathiran. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. And until tomorrow inshallah, at the same time for the third attribute of faith inshallah, keep us in your dua. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.